We're live. All right. Good morning. Wow. I got to tell you, I'm so excited to be here right now. I think it's probably uncanny. You know, it's the one thing that we, oh, by the way, my name is Steve Krivda. This is the Wednesday Word. Sorry. I got caught up running right into this, man. I've been listening very intently to God I'm doing all that I can, as my memory serves, to be with God. Do you notice how I'm very cautious on my words because I need to be honest and truthful? Well, the question really comes down into is this, is like, what's happening? Well, there are, obviously we have, and anywhere in the world right now, you probably know about what's going on. I'm not even going to speak the word because there's no reason to. But there's something going on that's impacting people, and it's fear. People would say, well, it's a sickness. And I don't believe it's a sickness. I believe it's the fear. It's a fear of what's happening. It's a fear of the unknown. It's a fear of what could possibly be coming. What's happening here? What's really going on? And I'm scared, and I get it. There was a long time in my life where I sat in a space of fear and not knowing what's coming. And because of not knowing what's coming, I would sit in a place of being frozen and being in my own mind. You know, I remember a time when, this is a slight offshoot, but it's a great understanding of fear, is that we had a brand new puppy last year around this time, and she developed this massive growth on her mouth. And it's crazy, beautiful little golden retriever. She's beautiful. I took her to the doctor. Took to the veterinarian, and the veterinarian says, oh man, that's a very aggressive form of mouth cancer that's common in those dogs. So I immediately took myself out of faith and put myself right into fear and detached myself from that doggy, because I had just lost a dog that I had for, I think, that time, 13 years. And I couldn't do it again. I couldn't go through that pain again. So I detached myself completely from this puppy. It became an animal in our house. I wasn't mean to it, of course. I fed it and took care of it. Except for I removed my love from that puppy. We took it to another specialist. The specialist said, well, you know, the possibility could be that. Also, it could be nothing. I'm like, okay. Well, as the time went by, the doctor, he ran some tests, and he says, man, I won't know until we operate. And the operation is going to cost this much. I won't tell you exactly how much it was, but I will tell you that it was not in the three figures, it was in four figures. So we had to make a decision, and we left the decision up to the boys, and they said, absolutely. So we did that. And as soon as the operation was over, we get a call from the veterinarian that it was just nothing. It was just a growth that happened to happen. There's nothing wrong with her, and she's absolutely great. Now, here's what happened. Because of that place of fear that I was sitting in, me detaching myself from her, I became very cold. And it took me about 3 months, maybe a little bit shorter, to start loving her again. Because I had detached myself, because I allowed fear to be so strong in my life that it completely took over. And that's exactly what, if you take a look around the world today, we're sitting and being gripped by fear. Because here's the question, what happens if the nation decides to shut down? And I'll be perfectly honest with you, I think it should. Because when I went out to the store this morning, there was packed with people bumping into each other, just like all up on top of each other when we're specifically told we're supposed to be this far apart. See, the fear isn't the virus. The fear is fear. We're afraid of not knowing what's going to happen. We're afraid of, well, let me ask you this question. When you think of the unknown, this space that we don't know what's going to happen, what color is the first color that pops into your mind? If you had your eyes closed, what color would pop in your mind? Well, if you're like most normal people, it's some sort of a dark color. Well, imagine for a moment that unknown is the glorification of heaven. Imagine if it's a sun shining of God shining into your life. Imagine if it's all the Holy Spirit speaking to you on a daily basis. Imagine if we shut our minds down just for a few minutes of this fear, this grip of fear that's clouding our mind and not allowing God and Christ and the hope of the Holy Bible to infiltrate our minds and our lives, what would happen if we just shifted for a moment? In Matthew 6:34, it says, don't worry about tomorrow. Each day has enough trouble. Tomorrow will have its own worries. See, every single day we have something to be concerned about. It's a matter of, are we going to allow this to completely control our lives? God says, trust me one day at a time. I understand this can be hard to do, especially if you're hurting or if you have times of trouble. But if you look around, the only thing, the only species on earth right now that is concerned are the human species. The animals don't care because they don't think. They don't see times of trouble. They sit in a space of survival. I need to wake up today and eat. And if I don't eat, I don't make it. They don't put emotions in it. It's just a way of life. We as a human being species, we've become very accustomed to have everything given to us. That we can jump on the internet at any moment of time, have a conversation with somebody somewhere in the world for free, face to face, and talk to them like they're sitting right next to us. We could pick up our phone at any moment in time and Google or go on YouTube and search the web for anything we want to search for and expect it to be there every single time. What would happen if we shut down for a couple weeks? Nothing. It would allow us an opportunity to connect with each other at a human level. I've been asking myself, what is this about? You see, God has a plan in everything that he does. I think we can agree on that. Everything that happens in the world is underlined by him. And we look at tragedies and things that are bad, negative, and we think, well, how could that be? So I asked myself, I was like, well, what is it that God wants from us at these times? And I was like, is it more belief? Do we need to believe more? Do more people need to believe and rely on God? Well, I'll tell you right now, there are more people that are not believing him, stating, if this was the case, if we're going through this turmoil right now, how could there be a God? Well, I don't think it's belief. I believe it's faith. I believe now more than ever, our faith needs to stand strong. I believe now more than ever that we need to take a look into the future and know that we're going to be okay because we have a caring, loving, amazing God, a grace-filled, merciful, loving God, a God that's not going to leave us unless we push him out of our lives. Now is the time that we should be praying together, not staying together. Now is the time we should be stepping into his life, not pushing him out. We should be eradicating fear and filling it with faith. I don't believe this is the end of times. I don't believe we're at the apocalypse. And I make jokes because, well, what else am I going to do? We can sit here and worry about things that we don't know. Or we can take a look at our history as human beings. See, God gave you a fighting spirit. God doesn't sit back and say, hey, you'll be fine, whatever. God gave you a spirit of strength. And how I know this is because it's said over and over again in the Bible, for I will never leave you nor forsake you. Why would the Heavenly Father that's created everything on earth leave you? The only way that he is not there is that we leave him. Trusting God is something we need to start choosing to do in a big, heavy way. See, when we worry about today and we worry about tomorrow, those worries, they start crisscrossing and meshing in our minds kind of like a spider web that will constantly continue to grow and stop allowing us to see hope. If you want hope in your life, ask God, what do I need to do? You know it's okay to be afraid, right? It's okay to be scared. I'm not talking about eradicating going, oh, you're a fool for being fearful. What I'm telling you is that once we understand that we're afraid, well, that's when we have a choice. Yesterday, I'm just going to be transparent with you. I sat for the first almost half of the day scared. What am I going to do? My business relies on people wanting to increase their own life. And right now, people aren't looking to increase life. Or are they? You know what I did yesterday to give y'all hope? Is I went, who am I going to hire next? I'm not sitting here waiting for things to happen. God does not want us to sit here and stand. He wants us to see that this, as in many times in the past, is a trial. Now, what does it mean? I don't know. It's not for me to know. He said, stand strong. These worries that we have, they create that, it's these things that we have in our mind, they create a web of worries that tangle up our thoughts and they leave us confused and they don't allow us to see a space of solution. So think about that. Imagine for a moment, your faith was so strong that you knew this is temporary. Is it going to be 2 weeks or 2 months? I don't know. It's not the question. The question is, am I going to make it today? Of course you are. I have a 6-month outlook that's very positive. Because what I've done here is this, and I'm going to let you a little bit inside of my mind for a moment here. And when I look at faith and strength in God and what he's doing for us here on earth, last night I went to our local supermarket and it was empty when we were done. Not because of us, but because of the massive amount of people in there. When I went there this morning to pick up something that I forgot, it was full again. It's packed. They filled the whole store was full again, except for a couple things here and there. You see, we're being provided for, except for we're not seeing the provided for. We're seeing that, well, what am I going to do? I'm going to not have whatever you feel like filling in the blank with. Well, let me ask you this question. As cruddy as things have ever gotten for you, hasn't God always provided for you? As money has been an issue, hasn't he always provided? As you've been hungry, hasn't he always provided and filled your cup? There's never been a time in my life where he wasn't there for me. He's always been there, every single time. It's whether or not I decide to receive him and bring him into my life. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I believe that more today than I ever have in my entire life. Don't get caught in this web. Trust God. Allow him to take care of you today and tomorrow and as far as you want to go. See, my mind goes 2 to 3 weeks out. What am I going to do for my family for the next 2 to 3 weeks? Just going to make sure they stay safe. Make sure they have something in their belly. My husband, my two cares. And then I skip past that to 6 months from now of this greatness that's happening in September when we're all out of this. The economy is booming again. People are back to work. And the life that we live now is not forgotten, but in the past. I watch a lot of shows and I read a lot of information on manipulation of the world and how we're manipulated to think certain things. And we're manipulated to think certain things by having things repeated over and over and over again. You need direction? Seek the Bible. Seek his word. You want things repeated in your mind over and over again? Seek God's word. When we seek God's word, there is nothing that can stop you. In Psalm 84:12, it says, Lord Almighty, blessed is the one who trusts in you. In the beginning, I said, or kind of in the beginning, a little bit in the middle, I always look at, you know, what do we need to learn here that we're not seeing? What's the underlying story that we're not seeing that's happening in the world today? What's the underlying message? What's not being said and we're not seeing in the words that's being spoken right now? And those are the questions that I ask myself. Well, I do believe 100% that those us believers, that our faith now needs to be stronger than ever before. God is giving us an opportunity to spread hope. And I'll be darned if I'm going to sit on my butt and wait for things to happen, because waiting is a space for the devil and he does not belong in my house. When I was out there today, I saw fear and panic in people's eyes. And that hurts. Today, I encourage you to sit down with God for 10 minutes. As soon as we hang up here, I'm going to go out and do it with my two sons. Sit down for 10 minutes only. You can do way more if you want to, but a minimum of 10 minutes. Quiet your mind. Take a few deep breaths. Be 3, 4, just. And have a good old-fashioned conversation with God. And say, God, what do you want me to do? Where do you want me to take this? What's our path? What do we need to do here to come together as a community? Whatever your question is for him, to help create a solution. God is solution-based, not problem-based. Take time and be still and learn from him. Listen for his quiet and gentle voice, because he's here for you. We've got to invite him in. So I love y'all. Let's end in prayer. I'm kind of emotional right now. He is very powerful, and I don't know what I just said a few minutes ago. But I can feel him in my house, because we've welcomed him in. Welcome him in your house today. Dearest Father in heaven, thank you for this day, for blessing us so richly, Lord, that we have you to look towards, not the media, not the government, not the people walking around with solemn and fearful faces, Lord, but we have you to look towards. The one of hope, the one of grace, the one of mercy, the one of forgiveness, the one of love, the one that guides us and directs us every single day. That all we need to do is ask for your help. Ask for you to come into our house. Thank you, Cindy. Asks. We just need to ask. And then quiet our minds. Allow that web to disintegrate, Lord. That fogginess that the devil is feeding us with right now. He is running rampant in our country, in our world right now, Lord. We need to drive him back where he came from. This is not the time nor the place for this battle. We'll see him soon. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for us and providing hope. Let us remember that word mercy and that word love. And help us see how we can help people. Let us be the beacon of light, not through our words, not through our Bible verses, but how we are, Lord, that we're living through you. That we are that beacon of hope, Lord. Help us have that strength, the courage, and the knowledge to speak life into people. And be with our family, Lord, and those that are scared, and all those we said we pray for. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Thank you for being here today with me. God bless y'all. We got this, because our Heavenly Father is there with us and he's got us. I love y'all. Speak to you soon. Bye-bye.